Dear Miss Hanf, I expect you are getting a bit worried that we have not written to thank you for your parcels and are probably thinking that we are an ungrateful lot. The truth is that I have been chasing round the country, in and out of various stately homes of England, trying to buy a few books to fill up our sadly depleted stock. My wife was starting to call me the lodger. She just went home for bed and breakfast. But of course, when I arrived home with a nice piece of meat, to say nothing of dried eggs and ham, then she thought I was a fine fellow and all was forgiven. It is a long time since we saw so much meat all in one piece.
Lots 40 through to 49 on the next landing.
Thank you. Good morning, John.
Good morning.
We should like to express our appreciation in some way or other. So, we are sending by book post today a little book which I hope you will like. I remember you asked me for a volume of Elizabethan love poems some time ago. Well, this is the nearest I can get to it. Elaine Hanf, with best wishes and grateful thanks for many kindnesses from all at 84 Charing Cross Road, London, April 1951.
To all at 84 Charing Cross Road, thank you for this beautiful book. I've never owned a book before with pages edged all round in gold. Would you believe it arrived on my birthday? I wish you hadn't been so over-courteous about putting the inscription on a card instead of on the flyleaf. It's the bookseller coming out, and you were afraid you'd decrease its value. You would have increased it for the present owner, and possibly for future owners. I love inscriptions on flyleaves and notes and margins. I like the camaraderie sense of turning pages someone else turned and reading passages someone long gone has called my attention to. And why didn't you sign your names? I expect Frank wouldn't let you. He probably doesn't want me writing love letters to anyone but him.